Somehow.
Like one of them is spicy, and the other one is hot. Boom. And then there's Moops.
Clap, clap, clap.
Wait a minute. Hold on. Hold on. Moops, how tall are you?
Like 5'11".
Okay.
Never forgetting.
Next intro, right? We gotta get this written down somewhere. We have to make an intro where we talk about being tall, but you guys make fun of me for being shorter than the both of you.
I forgot you were shorter than us.
The only thing I remember him being smaller than us in is fucking like years. I remember him, like he's younger.
Oh yeah, he is the youngest.
Who? Me?
You? Yeah.
What? How old are you, Moops?
28.
What the fuck is this? Been friends all this time. Never knew your age.
Yeah, because like, what was it? I think I'm older than Jess.
Yeah, about a couple weeks.
Yeah.
So I'm the shortest and the youngest. Holy shit! I'm just Onichans everywhere. It makes me sick.
Fucking do the Saitama thing where it's like, where'd this sassy lost child come from?
Or just start roasting you too and just like, hey man, you hear that? Yeah, some whiny bitch making noise again.
There's that 12-year-old. ready for the
yes
topic, whenever you are, Jess.
We are going to hit a topic we were going to do before but decided to do it now, which is the LOL, aka League of Legends fighting game, as far as our impressions go of it so far. We're going to hit on Stadia not coming with features as promised, and possible already failing now. Yeah, I mean, let's be honest, who didn't see this coming? But we're going to talk about Pokemon, Sword and Shield, and their whole controversy thing that's going on. Sonic actually getting the changes he needs in his new movie.
He found Jesus, to quote Yang Ye.
Might as well. I mean, literally with the glow up he just got. We're going to talk about Death Stranding impressions, reviews, and splitting of the audiences, and Echo Fox getting 100% dissolved, and also some other fun tidbits as we go along. But first, the League of Legends fighting game and what we've seen so far. So I'm just going to go out there and just say it. I really don't have that many impressions on it. We haven't seen a lot.
Because I'm kind of the same way, where in regards to what it is that like they've shown, it's basically nothing. And unless you know the like characters from the original game themselves, I don't think any one of us here has like an opinion on them.
Mm-hmm.
But this is also something of unique circumstance, because this is a big fucking rich-ass company, because let's face it, they make bank based off of that fucking League of Legends game alone.
Mm.
And it's also, like, the only game that they make. It's basically, like, Fortnite, but pre-Fortnite. Oh, God.
No dying on the podcast.
Ah, damn it. Sorry, Reaper. But it's a big company entering the fighting game genre, and it is kind of a curious case to see what they could do, considering what would be like, because like one of, for example, one of the notes that I have here on the my little note card for this is like what kind of features and modes like do you think that they would have? You know, what's like, because we assume that there's like some standards, but there's also the possibility of like, you know, what do you think that they're gonna throw in?
Well, if we're gonna go off of that base, I would think you would have to look towards a game that came out before this, which was Rising Thunder. And the main reason of that is because Seth Killian was working with them on this for very extensively. And they took that little thing off of it for Rising Thunder, which is why it got shut down, because they wanted the tech off of that. So that would probably be your best bet as far as a league goes. Now, if they're actually going to stick with that, who knows? But mainly because, like I said, Seth Killian is no longer working on the project. He's working on something else. But that is the basis we have to go on for now. Other than like the very small tidbits we saw, which is like literally the generic training stage that's in Street Fighter and stuff, and another desert area and a couple of characters. That was it.
Yeah. And I mean, like, I don't think anybody's surprised that the biggest thing was basically just the actual the announcement that they're doing it. Kind of like when Smash Brothers announced, oh, we're working on Terry. You got almost nothing.
Hmm.
But
it's really hard to beat that. Terry Bogard, it's just like, okay, well, we're just not going to do anything today. We're just going to go home, lay down.
Yeah, pretty much.
And wake up and get at him again.
Yeah, but I mean, like, if this game really wants to find success, they really do need to have the things that they need to have the parts that the FGC really wants to consider, they need to have the parts that the FGC considers to be standards, like, because they would be training modes, both online and offline, the working lobby systems,
frame data.
Hashtag last episode. I just made that up on the spot. What else? Different entertainment, like modes for like messing around with. Like say
consistency. Consistency.
I mean,
GGPO.
That's a big one.
Crossplay.
With no PC.
Yeah, fuck you, PC guys. I love you. Yeah. Fuck you.
It's just all the being prone to cheating that you guys don't want PC, right?
Yep.
Exactly.
Okay. Yeah, no PC either. Screw them nerds.
Because, let me ask you this, Jess. Because it's that. It's they could get GGPO for the game, right?
Mm-hmm.
But say that they were they were going for they wanted to make sort of like their own engine about this kind of thing, given that it's what the hell is it called, like Epic or some shit, or do you think these guys would be able to do it?
Oh yeah, the money and resources they have, absolutely. The question is it the right move to do?
This is true.
Is they also have to think of this as what the genre is in itself, which is, yes, it's going to bring a lot of people to it, but it's still a fighting game, and unfortunately it's still kind of a niche genre compared to a lot of other games.
Yep.
So you gotta play this smart.
Surprisingly, I think it's slightly less popular than MOBAs.
Hmm.
Yeah.
And another thing is that if you're expecting probably anything to be announced anytime soon, I would not hold my breath. Because this looked not even alpha yet, what they showed. If I had to take a guess, we might not even see anything till this time next year.
Yeah, probably like quarter three, quarter four.
Hmm.
I agree.
I mean, that's early.
And that's cutting it close.
Mm-hmm.
Well, say it's like, because I guess we can also dovetail off of that a little bit, because what's your guys' opinion on like how big the roster and stages should be?
Oh,
it can't have more characters than Tekken.
Well, yeah, that's a whole other thing in itself. It can't have more than Tekken. However, they also can't do what Granblue's doing and have like so few.
Yeah.
How many has Granblue got?
I think like 12.
Shit.
Like, it's like, Jesus Christ, that's it? Like, and it's like, God, it's so hard to not sound like an entitled bitch when you just hear 12.
Well, it's another problem with that is the fact that they've already announced DLC characters along with it.
I hate it.
Yeah. So, I mean, even so, like, 12 characters, it's still very small for that kind of a game.
It's like a small-sized roster for a Super Nintendo era.
Mm-hmm. Especially when you look at the Granblue series, which I will admit I'm not a fan of. I'm barely just now getting into it myself.
Yes.
But there's so many... I know, right? But there's so many known characters in the series as far as Japan goes, and such a big thing they could have made out of the roster that they're only the fact that they just came out with 12 is kind of weird, especially since one of the characters that is very important to the story is not in the roster.
Damn.
Yeah, so they can't. Riot can't do that. Absolutely not.
Yeah.
I hope they don't go into it treating it like it's League of Legends.
That too. Which also it also goes into like mechanics and whatnot of what they might do, because there could be like a cooldown period. Let's take for example Mortal Kombat 11 and the way they've done their cooldowny periods and stuff with the bars and whatnot. Mm-hmm. It could be that, but maybe even further. Just so that, let's say, like other MOBA-ish people can join in and get like some familiarity, I guess. It's mm-hmm. like, oh, it works like this or something like that. They could be even going farther in that direction. We don't know.
Yeah, they definitely like. How many would you like? So I guess if I had to throw out a number, like, would you say somewhere around like 20, 24-ish would be like a decent sized roster?
Well. Here's the thing, and my answer will only depend on one particular thing. Is it a single base or team base game?
Hmm. Okay.
Actually, I don't even remember if it is which one it is.
No, I don't think they've answered that yet.
If it's gonna have tags in it?
Hmm.
I don't know.
Because if it does, that changes the number for me.
Right.
Makes sense.
But if you like your number the way you put it, I'd probably be fine with that in singles. Maybe not so much in teams.
Makes sense. And but like at this point, it would also be more. I feel like it would be more disadvantageous if it turns out that it's teams and it is like a small roster. Because not only I feel like you'd also be pissing off like the Riot fans because. Like these guys have been playing this game for God knows how long, and they've come up with like shit tons of characters.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, everyone's like, this is one of the situations for them where they are easily not going to be able to please everybody.
Oh, so, well, that was not going to be a case in the first place, but
yeah, unless they would like, so they have to get like I guess the best way to put it is they have to put in the characters that have the biggest fan bases.
Mhm.
Like Akali.
Sure.
I'm about to say that's not like fucking virtual pop star.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. Points for me.
I'm glad one of us knows what's happening.
I like half know.
I think there's the Fox Lady somewhere in there, maybe.
Yeah, there's that wrong. Fucking like Kitsune Lady.
Thank you, Gmod.
And then, so let me ask this: in what do you think that like? Do you think they'll go overboard in regards to some of like the DLC practices, like characters or costumes? Because you got to keep in mind that, like, the actual core game itself, that shit's got a ton of fucking costumes at this point.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I think that there's, like, some characters with, like, around 20 or something, but that's just me throwing in, I guess.
Don't ask me. I'm going to say yes.
Because, like, I do have this one friend that he did play League of Legends, and I remember seeing, like, a ton of, like a big wall of costumes that he owned. And I don't even think he had all of those for that character.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's like, I know that costumes might actually be, like, a big thing for these guys.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, how do you think, like, that should be handled?
Well, I mean, as the thing goes over time, maybe they'll probably go into that, but... This is also almost similar to another situation we had with like Tekken 7 in its season stuff. This is a first for them as far as like fighting game stuff goes and whatnot. They could be approaching this just like they did their last game, and there could be a shit ton of costumes as it goes along. Or maybe Seth told them something about this when it comes to the FGC and they listened to him on that. I don't know.
Is this American devs, right? The guys that are working on this?
Good question.
I would say yes, but
from what I remember about that video, they said that like it's supposedly two guys that are like very prominent in the FGC.
Mm-hmm. That is correct.
But I don't know exactly where they're from.
Well, okay, so I can't remember their names, but one of them I know for sure is responsible for Evo.
Right, I remember that.
So, I mean, that person at least knows something FGC related.
Oh god, it's not Mr. Wizard, is it?
No, definitely not. Let's say, you ain't gonna have no sexy females in this game.
Right? Fucking core values.
I'm glad we muted out core values to this day.
They're never gonna live it down, and I won't let them.
They don't deserve to live it down.
Exactly.
But no, it's a very interesting thing. Like, until we really get more information, there's not a lot to really go on. Yeah, honestly, I think that's all I can really give on that.
I mean, it makes sense because a lot of this is up in the air question marks, because you can't necessarily just do like a shot for shot comparison of how they do their fighting game versus how they do their core game, since these are two totally different like projects and products.
Mm-hmm.
So let me ask you this though. How do you feel, like, what do you think they should do in regards to like FGC support? Like, how should they go about with this, since they're heading into a new community? They're basically the newbies, regardless of like any previous reputation.
I'd say go the Sam Show route. Get some community managers out there. Go to streams. Actually talk to these known people.
Get Don't ask me for shit.
Ooh, I don't know.
And possibly fuck up.
Well, that's the funny thing is, like thinking about that, if they did go the Harada route, I think that they would lose a ton of money.
And see, the main difference on that one is Harada has been here for a long ass time. So he's gonna have way more information than they are.
And I feel like he can do that because he's been here longer.
Yeah. Like, he doesn't really need that kind of support because he knows what he's doing.
Yeah, if you're a member of the FGC, like, you'll recognize Harada.
Hmm. Riot, I know that they kind of need that kind of support, that kind of communication.
Yep. And they need to try and bring in and retain the attention of as many core fans as they possibly can.
Mm-hmm. And we're talking like core fans, like after the sales and all that other stuff.
Not,
yes, sales would be nice, but keeping them is what they really need.
And not core values.
Exactly. But also, when I mean like core fans, I mean people that play like base League of Legends, because like some people I'm sure will be attracted to playing it because it's the franchise. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, you know. How long
is that shit going to be able to keep up?
Well, because they can even play it casually, that's fine. But the thing is, though, that they still need to find a way. They still make the game in such a way that it can keep the people that play base League of Legends, like, their attention as well.
Right. Like, Eddie, think of it this way. Look at what Negan and Noctis have done. These people who play them aren't really going to keep up with people like us.
Well, shit.
But they're really bringing people in that maybe can do that. Because I watched this person do it. Maybe I could do it too. That's all you need.
Pretty much.
Hey, no! Damn it!
Fool!
Anybody else was hearing a beeping sound?
Nope.
Okay, so I am losing my mind.
Welcome to the club.
Thanks, man. It's good to be here. I like
long time ago.
It finally feels good to be surrounded by people that I can relate with.
Especially that guy with the hat.
Especially that guy with the hat.
I love that guy with the hat.
look at the thing he's doing right now. Anyway. yeah, like, one of the big things about it is that, like, they need to keep the focus of, like, the people who played at their own game. And I think that they really need to do some stuff that can be seen as, like, how can I put this? Like things that they can do to attract, like, members of the FGC as a whole to really make sure that they can get, like, the proper hype and support that they need. Because, this is a game where if Riot really wants to, like, have a spot in the FGC, they are going to need, like, as much help from them as they can get. Because otherwise this game will fucking go in and out like that fucking Thunder game that you told me that you mentioned.
Yep. Here the gay, here the gay, nice.
Nice.
Here the day,
which game?
Rising.
Here the gay. I demand this man be canceled.
Quick, Jess, you pull out the Uno reverse card.
Oh, man, he's already activated my trip card. But no. Anything else we want to add on this one?
Nah, we still need more information before we go around passing judgment on shit.
Yep. Like, this is going to be something that's going to be analyzed for a long time, and whether or not it becomes, like, the redheaded stepchild of fucking Riot or not, it really depends on what they do.
I thought you was going to say the redheaded stepchild of fighting games, and I'm like, yo.
That's so
serious. There's plenty of those. There's plenty of those.
I'd honestly say
the 3D Mortal Kombat. Enough said.
Oh, okay. I was gonna say Street Fighter V.
It's like, oh wow, Eddie is insulting Street Fighter V again. Color me surprised. Insert Pikachu meme.
Your mouse not white enough though.
But anyway, but yeah, so let's move on to the next one.
Which is the Google Stadia story.
Oh, AKA, that's going to be rich right there.
Yeah, lots of stuff happening here. Let's be honest here. We had our doubts, and they're literally coming to fruition in front of our eyes.
Pretty much.
So, where to start with this one? Let's start off with its launch, basically, which is what it's going to be launching with. Or lack thereof. So, as far as the games that are coming out for Stadia, they're pretty much all old. Like, Assassin's Creed Odyssey. Old as in they've been out on other consoles. MK11, Sam Show, 3 Tomb Raider games, Just Dance 2020, and other, like 9 games in total, really. And on top of, the new game that's coming out called Guilt, which is kind of like a little Nightmares inspired game. And that'll be it for the launch. And then the next month, we're getting more games like Final Fantasy 15, Xenoverse 2.
Wow. Wow.
NBA 2K20.
Wow.
And more other old games.
Yikes. Like when you said Final Fantasy 15, I'm like, oh, you've got to be taking the piss on this one.
I wish I was.
I wish you were too, dude. Jesus.
I literally saw that list like, really? Of just, all the games.
I'm like, there's going to be another port of Resident Evil 4.
That would be better. That would be more hype than 15.
It really would.
It'd be much more hype.
It'd be better than the last 3 games I just threw out.
Especially Assassin's Creed. Like, come on.
That franchise has been dead pretty much since Black Flag.
Mm-hmm.
No, yeah. I'd say after Unity, it started to take the biggest dip.
Yeah, which was Unity?
Unity was the co-op one. You know, the actual good one.
Yeah. I can agree with that. But and then, like, the next month after that is going to be more old games until, I believe, February. where they finally get some exclusives. Well, two exclusives anyway, and one's a Times exclusive. Yeah, that it might as well get Pac-Man. It's gonna call it Get Packed.
Get
and the other, yeah, and the other is called Orcs 3, and that's the Time exclusive. So it's not even really exclusive to Stadia.
But wait, which one was the exclusive one?
Get Packed.
Oh,
and that's an actual name.
Mm-hmm. That's the actual name of the game.
Get Packed. Nice.
Well, I mean, other than Guilt, which comes out at launch, but that's another Stadia exclusive, but it's an indie title. So that's basically what you're going to look up as far as the lineup really goes for the next couple of months. Right. Now, let's look at the features that you were really supposed to be getting at launch, but you're not going to because they're not going to be out till next year.
Is this the Xbox One?
It's worse. At least Xbox One had TV.
At least the Xbox One had TV. You ain't never lied.
But some of the features that were promised at launch but won't be there is that you won't be able to use the Steam Connect launching, which is basically you were supposed to have your save and the cloud to where if you were playing, like, say, NBA 2K, whatever, and one of your streamers wanted to play, they can link up to that and then play with you at that very moment.
Right.
That's not going to be there till next year.
Nice.
State Share, which is supposed to allow it so that it's another kind of way to do it, but like easier for like on your internet and whatnot.
Right.
And then here's the funny one to me. Family sharing is not going to be there, which means that say that we were all living in the same house, right? And we were trying to use a Stadia account. In order for you to use the game, you would have to have your own account and the game bought on that account. Instead of the family sharing one, which was supposed to have it all on one account.
Nice.
Well, not nice because they're not getting that.
Like,
nope, not till next year.
I meant nice as in damn, eh? That's great.
Mm-hmm. And you're also not getting the Buddy Pass system, which was going to be one of those things like, say, I have Stadia, and Eddie wanted to try it. He could try it off of my account for 3 months for free.
Nice.
But now you can't get that until next year. So, I mean, can we just agree that this is basically just a beta?
Basically.
Did they learn nothing from Epic Games?
Clearly not. Oh, and you just reminded me of another thing that's going to be happening on launch.
Oops.
So basically, the launch is going to be staggered with people who got like the $100 thing with the controllers and whatnot. Mm-hmm. Not everybody's going to be getting it on the same day. Somebody could get it like 3 days after launch, or 4 days after launch, or another time after launch.
Damn you, Google, and your indie development.
No, right? Of all the things, Google indie development.
Like, seriously, this is the kind of shit you'd expect from like some random random indie dev making this kind of shit, where he's like, oh, well, you know, because I'm this once, like, we're just like a group of struggling content creators or some shit like that. Like, we're fucking, we're trying to get all these things, but we're getting some problems with this. Like, this is a fucking multi-billion-dollar corporation. It's like, yeah, we don't know how this shit works.
Clearly not, especially since one of the main ways you're supposed to be able to use it, the Chromecast Ultra. Yeah, if you own one, you can't use the one you own. You have to get the one they want you to get for now. And then they'll add an update later.
So they're basically pulling an Apple move as well.
Exactly. Speaking of which.
Oh, God, look at what you've done.
You started it.
I did.
Speaking of Apple,
I did. Reminding them about shit.
They're actually at launch. You won't be able to like get the games off of your computer and whatnot. And in order to set up like your account and stuff, you actually need your phone.
Why ain't that some shit?
Yeah,
that fucking gay shit.
Yeah. Some gay shit. Hella gay shit.
Yep, extremely gay shit. Yeah, yeah. So, I mean, overall, like, with all that, I'm pretty sure we can probably say Stadia's probably not going to do too well.
Nah, not at all.
No.
Which is actually, I'm laughing more at the whole it's going to be next year thing, because if you know anything about Google, the likelihood of that is slim to none, because if this doesn't succeed, it's not going to happen here anyway.
Right. Oh, like, fucking, they can't even keep their, like, most popular shit up to date. Fucking, like, everybody's hitting on YouTube right now. Mm. Like, harder than usual. It's like, if they can't get that shit going, well, what the hell hope does Stadia have?
As much hope as Google Glass.
That shit's fucking, like, Stadia's dead on arrival.
What the hell is Google Glass?
Exactly.
Okay.
All right. But Google Glass is supposed. Well, you didn't see. Wait. Did you see the last Spider-Man movie?
Homecoming?
Yeah. Not Homecoming.
Far from Home?
Oh, Far From Home?
Yeah.
New.
Yeah. Okay. So basically, they're basically like these glasses that you're supposed to connect to the internet and stuff like that.
Like computer glasses, I guess.
Yeah.
The hacker glasses.
Yeah. And nobody really bought it. So
$5 says it's probably because they didn't work.
Probably. Seems like a lot of things when it comes to Google. Oh man. So I mean, how long, I just would guess, like, how long do you think this is gonna last? Like Stadia,
a month at best.
I guess mine's the more hopeful thing, because I was gonna say two at most.
No. A month.
I'm almost one siding with Eddie here.
And you're right too, because that's like, I was just like, I was thinking like, three is already way too much. So like, I was thinking like tossing a coin between one or two.
Mm-hmm. But no, a month at best.
Mm-hmm. It's just, I don't understand. It's just like you said, multi-billion-dollar company, and you come out with stuff like this. Why?
Because it's almost like that shit you see on TV, where it's a multi-billion-dollar company, but at the same time they're telling them to build this game console out of like tissue boxes and band-aids.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, make this shit work. It's like, these don't run any current through them. What the fuck?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's all good. They're going to get their cheeks clapped, son.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention something.
Oh god,
I saw it in my notes. It's something like very minute, but it's like at the same time a little hilarious.
Right.
You're not gonna be able to see your trophies at launch.
What?
No, you're not. Like, it's like, it's coming like later at another day. They didn't even specify.
Is like fucking setting up a trophy system too hard for Google?
Yes.
Apparently so.
Do they need to, like, fucking Google how to do that shit?
Ironic, isn't it? Yeah, I saw that earlier today. I was just like, what?
Dude, like
basics.
it just seems like, A, basic, but also that stupid shit that, like, people hate when it's, we're promising you a product by this release date. The release date's coming. We're not even halfway done, but we're still gonna shove it out out the door anyway.
Exactly. This clearly isn't ready.
No, not even. But like, it's like behind. It's another like 4 years of development.
Mm-hmm.
And even then, when it comes out after those 4 years, it'll be obsolete.
Mm-hmm.
It was obsolete. It was obsolete in design.
Mm-hmm. Like, I was telling you, like, way back. Good in theory, probably terrible execution.
Yeah.
Probably the worst in execution.
Mm-hmm.
Fuck it. It's funny how, like, Nintendo's biggest failures are still better than this.
Oh, 100 times.
This reminds me of the Eminem and Machine Gun Kelly beef.
Oh man.
My biggest flops are your greatest hits type shit right here.
Yeah, it really is. That's exactly what I was thinking when you said that.
that one line right there. Boom.
Basically.
They're trying. They thought that because they're Google, they're just like, you know what? We're just gonna put our dicks on the table. Just, what's up? And just like, that's not gonna help us. What? People don't want to
dick away.
Yeah, like put your dick away. No one wants to see that. That's not gonna help us make more money. You just broke a table. Congratulations.
I'm sorry, I dropped my money.
Yeah, it's like you just broke a table and your dick's next to the salad bar.
I don't need to throw my dick. I have my money. But it's really like I'm just not understanding what the process is, because it's not even like they're gonna hit the fiscal year bad, because that's in March.
The fiscal year? Yeah.
Yeah.
Their fiscal year is going to be terrible.
Yeah.
Yep.
Like, I honestly don't understand, why did you do that?
Because, let's see, so far, off the top of my head, I'm counting two major fuck-ups for Google this year, which is going to be Stadia's news and the fucking YouTube, like, bullshit that's going on right now. I feel like there's, like, a trifecta waiting to happen.
Right around the corner. Will it be this year or next year?
Like, before the reports or after?
No, man. But no, that's the whole thing there with the Stadia.
Sounds like a clusterfuck that actually makes the Xbox One look good.
Yeah.
Surprisingly so.
And it's like, we never forgave the Xbox One for what it did.
No, we never did.
And you decided to fuck up worse than that? What the fuck?
Like, how, Sway?
It's like the whole fucking hold my beer meme, except that, like, Google saying that to fucking Xbox.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, if nothing else, I guess this might have given Xbox, like the shot for at redeeming themselves, because they're not the worst anymore.
Especially with new consoles coming out next year.
Yeah. But, like, who knows? This might give them the jolt that they need, because they can always say, well, at least we're not Google.
A lot of people will be saying that. Except for Bethesda.
Except for Bethesda.
Fuck it. Then next week they announce Fallout 76 coming to the Stadia. Well,
it's dead. You just had to put another name. Although I wouldn't be surprised if it's on their old ass lined up.
Seriously.
I think that's all I had for the reading on that one. Anything else we wanted to add on there?
Nah, man. I got nothing to add, baby. Google Stadia sucks.
Yeah, kind of does.
Hell, I'm more interested in the YouTube thing. I'm more interested in the YouTube thing than anything else.
There's so much weirdness happening with that.
But that's a minor thing. That's an extra thing. We can do that later. What's next, baby?
We could.
Yeah, let's talk about Pokemon.
Oh.
So, where to start with this one? Well, I guess we can start off with the ratings and why that kind of got weird.
Mm-hmm.
Because, lo and behold, Metacritic of all places gave Pokemon Sword and Shield an 81.
Wow.
Which is the lowest in the franchise. And when you look at, like, some of the scores and stuff, it's kind of interesting, because you have, like, places like IGN, which gave it a 9.3, but then you gave it like
how much water did this game have?
Clearly not enough. But I think you had like places like GameSpot, which gave it like a 6-ish in there.
I'm just laughing because I'm like, I hate that too.
Yeah. And it's kind of like the scores were kind of all over the place, really, for it. So it's one of those, like, well, I mean, let's be honest, who really looks at Metacritic these days anymore? But
like, nobody, like, at this point, nobody takes Metacritic seriously.
Hmm. Yeah, even still though, the fact that it's that low is kind of weird.
Well, because I mean, you. I think you told me that you had already seen like the whole hashtag thing going on.
I was just about to get to that, actually.
Yeah. So transition.
As I say, but that might be due to the whole hashtag thing now.
There you go.
So what originally started off this whole thing of like not get Pokemon Shield and all that stuff was the report that there was only going to be up to 400 Pokemon in this game, which brought in the whole like, where's the originals, like Charizard, well not Charizard, but like Bulbasaur and Squirtle and all the other ones.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the big thing of like, you know, where's the regional decks?
Yeah. And that brought up a whole hashtag on Twitter and whatnot, to which the creator of the game, well, not the creator, but like the main person for, what's the group name? iFreaks?
Game Freaks.
Came out with this saying that we're doing this to make the best game we possibly can, blah, 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 better animation. You know, corporate spiel. But then it came out later that when the game was kind of looked at more closely, that the game just seemed only more up-res from the last iteration that was made. And people were very upset about that because it's like, oh, he's lying. He's right. Telling us all this bullshit and whatnot. And you should be doing better. We shouldn't be buying crap and all this other stuff. And then everything got kind of divided because you have the group that's just like, well, we should be not getting mediocrity, versus the group that's like, hey, I can do exactly what I want to do in this game, and that's what I want to do, so I'm gonna get it.
Actually, yeah, because I bought my copy of Shield today.
There you go. To which case I'm on the side of do whatever the hell you want.
Honestly, yeah, the same. Because for me, it's basically like, and I showed the video to Jess yesterday about like the whole Mighty Keith thing, where he's like, okay, I can see the arguments that you guys are putting out there, but you know, I just want to go. I want to play Pokemon for playing Pokemon. I don't want to fucking go for like any of like the behind the scenes stuff. Like, in the same way that say, because you guys relate to this better, like some guy wants to play Tekken. Like, say Tekken 8 is like a real divisive game because it's like it doesn't perform as well in some of like the more competitive aspects, but it's still like a decent game. It'll be like, you know, you'll have some people where they're saying the game's failing because of this, because of that. It's got no fucking like frame data or anything like that. And then there'll be some people where it's like, you know what, I just want to play Tekken because I just like to play fucking Tekken. And for me, it's I just want to play Pokemon because I want to play Pokemon.
Play that motherfucking Pokemon, homie.
Yep.
Hey, live your life. I don't give a fuck.
He says to his podcast, bro.
But no, it's actually because honestly, I kind of chucked this up to something that happened, I believe, last year, which was Puddlegate, as we like to call it, with the whole Spider-Man water puddles debacle.
Oh yeah, that yeah. Shit. Yeah, that shit was hilarious.
I can see just the like, reflection. Yo, what is this garbage?
Yo, in Modern Warfare, maps that so happen to have a mirror in it, you can't see your character.
It's kind of funny.
Like, and it's like, and these people want to bitch about a water puddle.
I just checked that out to your character being vampires.
I honestly thought, you know, with as much blood as we spill in that game, you know what I mean? It's like, you know what? Just like, our characters aren't even human anymore. Just,
you know. I mean, that'd be awesome. Think about it. Because if they're vampires, then it turns out you're using, like, garlic bullets and fucking you gotta, like, fight other. You can't fight other people's
necks. Garlic bullets. I didn't sign up for this, but yeah, man, garlic bullets is the shit.
Knives, you got garlic bread.
Just whack it with a loaf.
That's great.
And it leaves like the indentations in their skin.
I'm so down for this. I'm getting the next card if that's the case.
Oh my god. I would play the fuck out of a game where it's like vampire shooter.
That'd be great. That'd be some lit shit, honestly.
Get to it, Kojima.
If anyone to do it, it'd probably be him.
Yeah.
An Activision, Sony, Microsoft, Kojima Studios collaboration.
No Activision.
Featuring Dante from the Devil May Cry. Oh, that'd be great.
Day one.
2 out of 10. Game of the year.
The campaign is Care Bear mode, normal, hardened, veteran, realism, Dante must die mode.
I'm sold. I'll buy the
Foxhound. Like Foxhound. Foxhound Dante must die double G. like just every tagline that you can put into it. Just
all the franchises.
Heaven or hell. Hell or hell. What's the main guy in the game? Eddie with the big beard?
Oh, Captain Price?
Yeah, Price mode.
Captain Price. Oh God! If Captain Price mode existed, may God have mercy on all of our souls.
Price must die.
Let's be real here. Like that's a travesty right there. I wouldn't wish that on my worst enemies.
I would. Those guys suck.
I would. Those guys suck.
No. But also actually going off to that point that you were talking about, you just getting it. I have a question for you guys.
What's up?
Do you think this whole controversy S thing will actually affect the sales?
No.
I think you might see like some dip, but a dip big enough so that Game Freak might actually have to do something about it, but nothing like super big.
Fair enough. To be honest, I don't really think so. Now, I'll tell you one example that kind of makes me think this way.
What's up?
And that is Borderlands 3.
Because the game is deeply rooted in its core like that, you're thinking it'll be just like Borderlands, where it's just, hey, play Borderlands. Playing Pokemon is the selling point of Pokemon.
Exactly.
Plus, I feel you.
Who's the one who's probably mostly going to get this game? Parents who are going to get them for their kids. They're probably not going to be on Twitter.
Shit. There's too many grown ass men grew up on Pokemon. Those are the people that are getting it.
Like, that's what I'm saying, casuals.
Yeah, casuals.
Yeah. Yeah, so you have like literally those two big crowds. I'm not seeing there gonna be that big of a dip, in my opinion.
Probably not. No, definitely not at all.
Yeah. I mean, because like the reason why I will say like I will leave some question mark there is because since we're not really rooted into like the whole Pokemon scene, we can't say for sure how like big it'll affect it. So it's like, do we think so? Probably not. But at the same time, like, how connected are we to the scene? You know,
I'd say
we are not connected to the scene at all, baby.
Say, yeah,
exactly.
We don't know. We don't know shit.
Did you say Pocket Mortys?
No, I said Michael Jordan said fuck them kids.
It was I think it'll be alright, but it's crazy because the Pokemon fan base got more toxic than the Smash in this instance. So we don't get to make that distinction. We're not as strongly into either of those games.
Yeah, I take showers.
Yeah, I take showers. Ooh, you got me good. That was great. That was awesome. We take showers. Even when we're depressed, we take showers still. So you know.
Yeah, but how else do you hide the tears?
Don't make me put on Juice World.
It's just I know way too goddamn well that I'm not a Smash player. I have like 3 different deodorants sitting on my desk. I got some carpet cleaner. I have some Listerine just sitting up here.
And like, I never bullied any women while being super racist.
Bingo.
I've done both of those things, but just never together.
God damn it.
It wasn't, you're a Smash player.
It wasn't together. It doesn't count. Come on.
That makes it better.
Like, come on. Like, I'm just being American. Come on. Come on. Don't be like that, guys. Come on. America first, guys.
I thought this was America.
I'm sorry. I thought this is America.
Travis Gambino's behind you with a gun.
It has that character from Fallout. Just like, the truth is, the game was rigged from the start. Did he shoot me in the mouth? Like, yeah.
Oh man. Y'all enjoy your Pokemon. I don't care. I don't have a Switch anyway.
It doesn't bother my wallet none.
No, they didn't fucking stop me from getting it.
Hmm. Also, first impressions I've seen, the people are going ecstatic for the game anyway.
Yep. Plus, they've confirmed so far that there's only 400 in the game right now.
Yes, it is confirmed.
Okay. Yeah, because the reason I ask is because there was this list that a friend of mine showed me that showed basically like all the Pokemon that were missing.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of the ones that seem to be on that list, but I mean, like, I guess I don't know how confirmed it would be at this point, but the ones that they had on the list that were missing were like, it was pretty much the newer the gen, the less likelihood they were in.
But you know what? I think I would rather it be like that, because at that point, they would be more likely to add the newer gen in the future.
Pretty much.
As opposed to, like, it's like, because imagine having Charizard as a DLC. People wouldn't let them sleep for the rest of their lives. They burn them at the stake. Dude, just for the just for the audacity. Imagine Pikachu as a DLC.
Oh, yeah, that one, they'd fucking burn down buildings.
Big old oof.
Yeah, exactly. It's like, if they have the core Pokemon in, and we know good and well how rushed these developers get to make these deadlines, I'd be surprised if there's any game that comes out finished.
Look, yeah, literally. I think that for Game Freak, they've had this, like, I think it's like an amounting problem where they almost have to make an annual Pokemon release, so that definitely puts a lot of strain on them as well.
Yeah, it helps them keep the license and whatnot.
Yeah.
Fuck that thing, but that's the way it is. It kind of sucks.
Yeah, it does.
There's a little part of me that would say, like, don't be surprised if they would be announced like a Super Sword Shield.
Oof.
Yeah. Pokemon Deus Ex Machina Edition.
No, man.
Yeah, who knows? Because what was it, like, the rumored one? Like, Pokemon Gun?
Pokemon nice. Gun.
Yeah, there was a meme that was going around called Pokemon Gun, and then I forgot what the other one was.
I thought it was just Gun.
It might have been just Gun. But I feel like there was a gun and something else.
Yeah, because I think it was supposed to be, I think it was just Gun because it was supposed to be kind of like the whole like Ruby Emerald Pearl kind of thing. Or not, Ruby Emerald Sapphire kind of thing. It was supposed to be like that. Fucking, I don't know what's going on with my brain right now. But yeah, it's basically like Gun is supposed to be the Emerald equivalent to that.
Right. Yeah, it's fun. But,
get what you want and play with whatever you want.
Yeah. Anything else we want to add on this one?
Nah, man.
Alrighty. Let's get to... for life. I don't know who that is, nor do I care. Let's go on to Sonic being saved.
And it only cost them Gangsta's Paradise.
Yep.
No, absolutely not. I don't know. I don't know who the hell do you think you are, Moops.
I'm Moops.
But it's already been memed to hell, though. I mean, is it really that much of a loss?
No, not really. It's just a dope. It's just a dope ass song. That's all that. That's all that was.
I'm not disagreeing on that.
Yeah.
I just gonna, like, TikTok ruined my whole thinking of that song.
Really? I'm surprised TikTok did that for you.
Once you see enough memes, you just
they just overlap. I feel you on that.
But I mean, I'm not gonna lie. I kind of wish this kind of power of the fans was back when a certain other movie came out. That being Dragon Ball Evolution.
Oh, right.
Oh, yeah, I've seen that picture too. Because it was basically that, like, it basically said something along the lines of that, of like, you know, I wish that we had the power of the fans to change this. And it was like a picture of Piccolo.
Nice. Although it takes way more than that to fix that movie.
Oh, God, yeah.
True that.
It's basically like it's not a case of, like, you know, you gotta rewrite it. You gotta fucking scrap the whole fucking thing.
Mm-hmm.
And pretend it doesn't exist.
Just burn it. Just keep everything. The only thing you really need to keep is Chi-Chi, because she was Asian at least.
Like, even then, that's pushing it, buddy.
Yeah.
Don't get me wrong. It's very pushing it.
Mm-hmm.
But she was kind of hot. But,
she could play the older Chi-Chi.
She could play Dragon Ball Super Chi-Chi.
The one in the tournament, for God's sake.
It's like...
But yes, she is Asian.
Yeah. You make good points.
I just hope they wouldn't meme the shit out of the second one. Like, Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon type shit.
Oh, jeez.
It was great, but come on now. It's objectively weird.
Oh, yeah, that didn't really age well over time, let's be honest.
The funny thing is, I thought even for its time, I thought it was weird.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, it was definitely even weird for its time, but even now it's weirder.
It just doesn't age well, period.
Yeah. No, it's just at its age where people don't appreciate it for the classic that it is.
Mm-hmm. No, well. Have you seen the trailer, Eddie?
The new one? Yeah.
What were y'all's thoughts on it?
Yeah, it looks good. I still want Gangsta's Paradise in it.
Why should it be like in the end credits?
I was thinking either that or like fucking they put in like a little Easter egg where Sonic turns on the radio, it starts playing for a couple seconds, then he turns it off.
Really fast.
Yeah.
He just breaks out into sweats, just like, you know what?
Nah. Maybe no music.
Maybe not this song.
But I mean, like, it definitely doesn't look as bad as I thought it would be, but then again, we saw it at its worst, so. Like, yeah. we saw when the movie had a crack problem, so mm-hmm. It's kind of hard to tell if it's like me thinking it's legit good, well, better looking, or if it's like, you know, because I have a comparison point.
Mm-hmm.
I'll definitely go watch it though, because like one of the sentiments that I actually agree with that I've been seeing on the internet is that people want to go see like even if people don't think it looks all that great. They do want to go see it to support the fact that they actually listen to people.
Yeah, exactly. Like, that should be the main reason why they go and see it now.
That's the main reason I'm going.
Okay, nice. Good shit, guys. I never shat on it, so I don't have to go see it. I'm not contractually obligated as per par diem of the internet.
Yeah, but I'm with you on that whole, like, if it's, like, seen through rose-glass eyes thing.
Yeah.
Because, like, when I was watching, it was like, Jim Carrey's nice. He's actually a little surprising for Robotnik.
Like,
you think they go with somebody fatter?
You would think.
Holly was not allowed to have fat people, though.
You know what? In this point in time, I would not be surprised.
Fucking, what's his name? I think Jonah Hill. He stopped being fat.
That's because he just was doing so much that he lost weight naturally. That's a joke. He made the active decision of getting in shape. Kind of like Josh Peck did.
For him.
I actually worry about Jonah Hill because he tends to go in between a lot. Like, he'll be, like, fat once and then, like, thin, and he'll be fat again, and then he'll be thin again.
And it's, like, the shifting that's probably bad for his health.
Very bad. I mean, I know it's an acting thing, but at the same time, that's not good.
Yeah. I mean, like, because if we were to pull, like, fat actors off the top of our head, probably Seth Rogen, but he would not make a good Robotnik.
No, definitely not.
Isn't that laugh coming from him?
He's too funny.
Yeah.
I'd say. Like, because Seth Rogen is more of a comedian than an actor, if you ask me.
I can see that.
I've seen him in a serious role. It wasn't that good. I'll probably take my niece to see it. She'll probably enjoy it more than I will.
I'm going to see it on principle.
Well, yeah, that too. But like, where I go, it's like, yeah, let's go see it. That way you can shut up for like 5 hours.
I mean, like, I will say also that in fairness, like, there were like a couple jokes in there that did like get a chuckle out of me, so it's like, okay, it thankfully doesn't look like it'll be as like horrible as I thought it would be.
Yeah, but you're not a comedy critic, you love shitty jokes.
Yep.
you don't get to make that distinction.
I mean, why would anyone want to be a comedy critic?
I honestly don't understand how anybody can be a comedy critic. Like, oh man, this stand-up was terrible. It's like, motherfucker, I came here to laugh. And laugh is what I'm gonna do, by God.
I'm gonna go home and watch Sticks and Stones.
Yeah, exactly. Or go home to watch the No Name Podcast, episode 26, live now on...
on Twitch. Or maybe check out any other of the episodes.
I'm just saying, it's 26 of them, guys.
Come on.
At least.
We made 26 of them. You can at least watch one. Come on.
Yeah. It's 2019, guys. Come on.
Almost 2020, guys. Come on.
Stop. It's like, it's almost 2020. Stop grind shaming, all right? Like, I don't appreciate all this grind shaming. Like, yo, look at this dude out here grinding. It's point and laugh.
I always kind of wonder about those people. It's like, do you know what world we're living in?
Like, this is the first time I'm hearing of it, and I don't want to, like, dig any deeper into it. I'm sure I would fucking hate the people that came up with that phrase.
What, shaming?
More like grind specifically thing. Grind shaming.
Oh, no, I made up grind shaming on the spot.
Okay, so then I don't have to hate you yet.
What? Yet? I thought you already... What?
Yet.
I thought we...
Never know what the future holds.
You do like us.
I thought we crossed the hate threshold like 13 episodes ago. What the hell happened? You getting soft on me, Moops? You getting soft on me?
No, you see, we've already reached the arc of, like, we've passed the hate arc, and right now we're in the love arc. Before we hit the rival arc, and then we finally hit the disbanding arc.
Okay.
It's like, it's we're past Saiyan Saga, and we're basically, like, around Cell.
Man, Cell Saga is a great saga.
Eventually we'll get to the Majin thing, and then we'll all break apart.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh,
and
man.
Eddie's gonna fucking sacrifice himself to fight Majin.
It'll be great.
All because Vegeta's my favorite character. I feel like I'm being Vegeta shamed here.
I was trying to give you Vegeta because he's your favorite, but okay, fine.
Exactly. Because he's my favorite, I'm being shamed for liking Vegeta. I don't like
it. Makes you feel any better, and Moopsy can attest to this. I like Vegeta more than Goku.
Yeah, but your favorite is Piccolo.
Exactly.
I mean, I'm like, I don't care. I like Goku just the same.
Piccolo was a G. He took care of the kids.
And as an older brother, I can appreciate the grind.
Exactly.
He sacrificed getting stronger to make sure the kids were all right. You think Goku does shit like that? Your idol moves. I'm fucking with you.
I'm counting all the times that Goku sacrificed himself for his kid.
What? That ain't important. I'm talking about the now.
That's the time of Cell, right? Where like he died and then Cell came back and didn't matter.
It was about that count.
Like,
you don't think Cell and Senzu be a thing, right? It's a thought that counts, though, right?
I think that was the turning point of people actually liking Goku right there. It's just it's like this guy is just a gallant warrior who's happy about just fighting, but as soon as he tosses out that sensor beam, it's just like, yo, is this dude a fucking moron? What the who does that? It's like he's tired. Yeah, that's what happens when you fight.
He wanted to think of number one knucklehead saying Naruto had already the knucklehead part though.
Like every time Goku does a dumb thing, it's just like, yo, that blow to the head really changed this.
It must have been a real slow burn.
like my god.
And Sonic.
Yeah, I was gonna say,
oh yeah, right.
Well, I was actually gonna ask you, do you think the Super Sonic will actually pop up in the movie?
Probably not.
Because right now, like, literally all we get is Sonic. We don't even get the others.
For me, it would be like fucking first worry, because I doubt that they're gonna make a mention of the Chaos Emeralds. But then again, because I don't know. There's that whole thing about, like, that they say in the trailer where, oh, they people want my power, so I have to go to your world. And I'm like, what?
Yeah, I don't get that either. I'm just rolling with it.
Yeah, I'm just like, it's just like, guys, stop pushing your luck. Just be happy I'm going to see it because you listen.
That was the worst retcon in Sindel.
Yeah. This point, I'm just giving you Sonic movie. Make more sense than a change now.
Yeah.
But, I'm just gonna let that point just go away. Just try to enjoy the movie.
Yeah.
But, anything else we want to add on Tonic?
Nah, man. Go support the movie. They listen.
Yep.
They did listen. Now, we can go on to Death Stranding.
Hooray.
So, how is the delivery base game?
The delivery boy simulator.
I mean, I'm still like, I'm having lots of fun with it. I guess you could say this. Proof that I'm having a lot of fun with it is because I keep spending too much time in certain zones.
That seems to be a thing with a lot of people who are playing it. It's like, go to the main story.
But I gotta make these deliveries, man. I literally had, like, today I literally had a pizza delivery to do. And I was like, okay, what's the best way I can make this pizza delivery?
I did hear about, like, players who couldn't get deliveries done. Other players would go out and help them with their deliveries and shit.
Yeah, that's a mechanic.
I'm like, you know,
thing is very interesting.
Like, it's like, you know what? Humanity ain't as bad as I thought it was, dog. Like, yeah. Humanity really out here thriving in the video game world.
In the real world, however.
In the real world, however, yeah.
We don't talk about the real world. It doesn't exist.
I just stabbed you as soon as I waved at you.
And they people say video games cause violence. Nah.
Yeah, man.
Like, I'm out here catching Pokemon, delivering packages, but sure, I'll shoot up a school.
That's on the to-do list, right? Yeah, but I've looked into a lot of streams and stuff on the game, and I'm not going to lie, the amount of Easter eggs they put into this is actually fairly cool.
Yeah, Kojima really loves to, like, chuck his shit full of, like, tons of stuff. What was it? In, like, say, for example, Metal Gear Solid 4, he would put in stuff throughout. Like, he'd pepper shit from all of the previous Metal Gears up to that point.
Mm-hmm.
And he would even throw in some other shit, like, from some of his other games that he's made, too. Like, there's this one game, I don't know how many of our listeners would remember this from the Game Boy Advance days. It was called, Django.
Mm-hmm.
And it was this little, this little kid vampire hunter, and he had, like, this gun that collected sunlight. And they legit put that gun in the fucking Metal Gear Solid 4.
Mm. Nice.
And one of the fucking stupid things was, like, fucking, like, in the game, the way that, like, you get sunlight is because, like, the kid holds up the gun to the sky and actually yells sunlight and starts fucking collecting it, right? Mm. In Metal Gear Solid 4, you could literally get Solid Snake to do the same thing. And, like, his fucking old, gruff-ass voice, he'd fucking yell, "Sunlight!" and hold the fucking thing up to the sky.
That was silly.
It was amazing. He's
silly, man.
He is. He makes great shit. When not fucking under pressure.
But no. I'm actually waiting on you to hit a certain point, because there's one Easter egg I really tell you about, but I'm not going to yet.
I can say I'm at chapter 3. Do you know what chapter he was at?
I want to say chapter 5. Okay. He was pretty far in.
Okay. Yeah, because, like, what was it? The last 2 or so days, I was spending a lot of time building this bridge for, like, this little deserty region.
Mm-hmm.
I was fucking delivering packages, fucking collecting materials, and then as soon as I'd get those materials, I'd fucking build, like, huge chunks of the bridge, just fucking, like, absorbing as many likes as I could, because fucking people really appreciate that bridge, but nobody wanted to build that bridge.
That's because it took a hell of a lot of materials, didn't it?
Yeah. From what I remember, I think one of those, like, aspects was, like, 3,000 or something like that.
Yeah, something crazy.
Yeah, but I mean, like, it started off at, like somewhere around 1,000. But, I mean, point is that, yeah, I fucking built and, like, and I'm just sitting here collecting the rewards.
Mm-hmm.
Nice.
And the story is, it's still way fucking out there. Like,
of course, as a Kojima game would be.
That too, but I mean, because of the slow advancement, I'm still not anywhere near a point where I can say, like, oh, I know exactly what fucking happened in the history. Like I said, mm-hmm. I'm only in chapter 3 still.
Mm-hmm.
So I still don't know exactly what happened with the world. But it's a game where, like, the gameplay is, like, actually pretty goddamn addicting. But like you said, Jess, I can see why people would I can see part of the reason why people would be, like, turned off by it.
Which goes into the whole splitting of the audience, because when it comes to reviews of this game, they are effing everywhere. They go from, oh my gosh, this game is great, I'm so happy he made this, to what the hell is this?
Because I gotta imagine that some people were just expecting him to go back to a Metal Gear style franchise.
Which, I mean, that's on you. I'm sorry, if you don't know Kojima.
Yeah, because I was just saying he made some fucking vampire hunting games, so you really think that he doesn't want other things to do?
Mm-hmm. Like, that literally, if that's what you thought was gonna happen, then, ooh, man, I don't know what to tell you. Especially after the whole thing that happened just before this, I don't even think he wants to go near that kind of franchise right now.
Oh, God, no. Horror games, maybe, but...
Yeah.
But Metal Gear style, no.
Not his thing.
Not anymore.
But you know it might be his thing. Monster energy drink. Yeah.
I wonder what he did to get that sponsor. Or not even, you know, sponsor. Just just to see, like, what did he do to get that?
You know what's funny is that for me, I almost feel like they went to him.
As blatant as that sponsor is, I can see it. Because, I mean, that is extremely blatant.
Yeah, because it's extremely blatant, but at the same time, think about it. It's when fucking Kojima left Konami, he fucking, like, just went straight to Sony and is like, they were, the moment that he fucking joined, they were like, do whatever you want, we're fucking keeping our hands out of this. So it's like, why would he need the money? So it's like there would be no reason. So, like, how else would they get their fucking games or their drink sponsored in the game?
But what if he did go to them? Be like, I really like Monster Energy Drink. It's what keeps me going.
If he did, I feel like I wouldn't be surprised, because he kind of is like, how can I put, like, the best way for me to say it is, like, he kind of does his own thing. So if he did go to Monster Energy and ask him so that he could put it in the game, while, like, there would be, like, a group of people fucking going, like, oh my god, he's a sellout and all that shit, I'd be like, dude, you guys don't fucking know Kojima then. Like, from what I remember, there was a ton of, I believe there was, like, good chunks of product placement in his other games, too, where they started getting, like, real fancy.
People don't know, like, the Calorie Mates in the Metal Gear series is a Japan-made product.
Yeah, see?
The only reason I know that is because I learned about that very recently. Because, you know, weeb shit.
Rowdy told you.
Actually, no, not Rowdy.
Although, I wouldn't be surprised if it was him.
No, not at all.
Yeah, nice. But it's like fucking, what was it? Because he had like some characters from some other fucking like shows and shit as little like hunting items so that you could get like the best secret gear or like all that kind of stuff. He's not afraid to fucking throw in like some kind of product placement-esque kind of shit.
I know. Even though it's planned, it's still funny. But yeah. As far as the splitting audience goes, Moopsy was saying earlier, I can see how people can like think maybe it's too slow or whatnot. Maybe it's not their speed per se.
Or their style.
Yeah, or their style. Although Kojima did recently come out with a statement that I think he could have worded better, which is the whole like, United States really is more of the Call of Duty kind of area and whatnot. To be paraphrasing, really, but it's basically what he said.
Yeah, it's like that's like the general idea.
And I wouldn't say he's necessarily wrong, but I think he probably should have worded it better.
Nah, that was the don't ask me for shit.
It kind of was.
He kind of can't pull that off too, honestly.
Yeah, the only other person that could ever pull that off was Kojima, and he did it. So yeah, you know.
I mean, game's out. People have already bought it. At this point, who cares?
Yeah, but yeah, it's like either you're getting it or you're not.
It's Kojima, man. There's a million people in the world that will hold his dick while he pisses.
You're talking to one of them.
Excuse me? You mean you're talking to three of them?
No.
Just two.
Come on, Jazz. It's 2019. Get with the program.
You know me?
You make me sick.
Virgins normally do.
What? Why did you bring your own virginity into this? That's a cheap shot. You can't do that.
He's like, what am I supposed to say about that?
Yeah, like.
You see, Eddie, he did that because now Jazz wins. He left you speechless.
Yeah. Go to the next subject. I'm sick of this nigga, dog.
I should not be drinking Coke at the same time.
Yeah, probably not.
Yeah, definitely not. You should have known doing this podcast, you would have laughed a lot.
Yep.
We done with Death Stranding?
Absolutely.
I'll say also, because I do want to get like a review number out.
Mm-hmm.
If I had to give one, mine would be 9 out of 10.
Nice.
Nice. That is some gangster shit right there.
Nip, nip, nip. Alrighty. We can move on to Echo Fox getting 100% dissolved. Which, honestly, if you've been listening to the pods, you know that's probably been coming for a long time.
Yeah, it definitely was.
Now, some reports are saying that this may be due to the fact that Echo Fox didn't get into the League of Legends Championship Series, which is kind of like the final straw with the whole, like, scandals and all this other stuff was happening.
Mm-hmm.
People were just pulling out, saying they're done with this, it's going too far down. And also, there was apparently another thing where I've got one of the business partners named Vision Esports or whatever, filed a lawsuit against the owner, Fox, for a breach of I'm going to butcher this word. Fidakiri? I'm going to leave it at that. And basically what that means is that he made a decision that wasn't great with the like investors and the other people at the company.
Right.
Which, of course, goes against the corporate laws and whatnot. And then a lot of other things that apparently, according to, is why this happened. Although, according to a lot of people, event hubs, but you know, a lot of reports. Of course, I think this is a long time coming, and I also think that Mr. Fox himself knew this before the debacle even happened, which is why he did it. To get out.
I'm pretty sure he fucking knew that roughly around the time he just bended the fighting game arm.
Exactly.
Yeah, he's just like, yeah, this is about the end, but shit, man, when that man was on top.
Oh, yeah, ooh, he wouldn't be stopped.
That dude was a motherfucking legend.
Mm-hmm. He would not be stopped. And then he had all the people with him in his company to help him with that as well.
Yep.
Well, speaking of which, let's go down the list of people who are affected with this, shall we?
Okay.
One person you might know, you might have heard of his name, Sonic Fox.
a very young and up-and-comer in the scene, if I say so myself.
I believe I've heard something that he is gay. But don't quote me.
They
are
gay.
Whoa, what?
Yes, quite.
Well, let me ask you this, though, because I feel like I'm going to forget otherwise if I don't say it now. What do you think are the chances that he could, like a ton of other teams are going to be drafting him, like fucking Kobe or some shit?
Oh, I'm not going to be surprised if they haven't been trying to before this even happened.
It's fucking Sonic Fox, dog. Like, the most decorated fighting game player.
I mean, literally won esports player of the year last year. Come on. They've been trying to get him even before this happened. I guarantee you.
Now I'm sure they're really going to step up their game.
Oh, yeah. Especially now. It's just like, well, now you don't have any prior engagements. somebody's going to scoop him up quick if he doesn't, like, say no to everybody. I mean, at this point, he's probably made enough to do that.
Yeah, because I was going to say, what about, like, the possibility that he might just make
his own team?
Yeah.
That's not too bad an idea.
Yeah, I wouldn't say it's out of the realm of possibility.
It ain't impossible.
Yeah, because he would need just, like, someone to help manage it, but...
Which, I mean, I'm sure you can find somebody.
He's Sonic Fox, for fuck's sake.
Yeah.
It's A, he's Sonic Fox, and B, I'm sure he's fucking made, like, tons of fucking connections.
Mm-hmm.
And C, he's Sonic
sure
Fox.
Can pay them.
A point so good, you have to mention it twice.
I think even his brother, has some experience in that. If he really needs it, he can probably go to him.
Yeah.
But yeah, honestly, that would be interesting though if he did do something like that.
What would he name it though?
That is a great question because he is very lewd.
Yeah.
He is into furries.
No, never mind that. I thought my Twitter wasn't safe for work. This nigga. Like, God, like, it's just like the biggest pervert in the world. It's just like, Jesus Christ, Sonic Fox, relax.
I still laugh at the reaction with Ernesto when he said that, like, Sonic Fox fucked two dudes.
Damn, two dudes at the same time? Yeah, like,
same time?
He stops the episode to just go, like, really? Same time?
Damn.
gangster shit right there.
I was thinking, too, that it's, like, fucking props.
Just like at the same time, like most of us can't even get threesomes with one woman involved. Like what? What? You mean to tell me this dude convinced two other dudes? Jesus Christ!
Can't even get it on with their hand.
It's like the drip of this man. Like this man is dripped out. Jesus fucking Christ, my man.
No, but he's probably the biggest one as far as who got affected that's still on the team. But as far as fighting game people go, there's also the Kill It Sage, MK Leo, and Mewtwo King.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they are all free agents as of right now. Although I do believe that MK Leo is in talks to be on another team right now.
I wouldn't be surprised, especially coming out of EVO like that.
Yeah. So he'll probably be good, but it is going to be interesting to see where the others go because I'm not so sure that they're going to get the same money that they got Echo Fox from.
Probably not, because a lot of times, usually like when you sign up to a team, you have to bring in the tournaments and shit so you can. Cause I think it's like you get your raises out of that essentially.
Mm-hmm. Like, you gotta really place. Like, I did this, 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 and this.
Yeah. Leo, I think he might end up being in a good spot because he won EVO, so he might be able to, like, negotiate, like, above minimum wage for that part.
Mm-hmm.
The other two dudes, I'm not entirely sure, and Sonic Fox, I feel like if he plays his cards right, he might end up even getting a raise from what he was getting at Echo Fox.
Mm-hmm. Honestly, Mewtwo King, he does good enough social media. He might be fine. The other one, the Kill Sage, I'm not so sure about.
What's he mostly playing?
I believe it is Smash.
Hmm. So it's basically like Sonic Fox and like three Smash players?
Yeah.
Hmm.
Because when I looked him up, that was one of the things that really came up was like Smash. He could be unknown in another game. I don't know him that well, and that kind of goes to my point. It's just like, I know these other three. Who are you?
Yeah, I know Sonic Fox, I know Mewtwo King, and I know MK Leo.
Yeah. But, good luck to that guy. Whatever happens then.
Like, wait, good luck to that guy, because if it's like, if he's the unknown out of that group of like the four most famous, then he's going to be in trouble.
Mm hmm. No, but this whole thing, like when you posted this, Eddie, I literally didn't even think I was like surprised. I was just like, it was only a matter of time.
Oh, wait, what are you talking about now?
When you posted the whole Echo Fox thing dissolve.
Oh, thing. Yeah, it's just like, okay, so it finally went down.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think we were all on the same page.
And I think all four of those guys are going to get raises by default because they stayed.
Mm.
Okay, y'all disagree with me. Okay, right.
Like, I can see
Sonic, I can see Fox and Leo.
Yeah, I can definitely see Leo. Mewtwo King is up in the air. It's possible. I'm not fully seeing it.
I can see him getting at least what he was getting paid at Echo Fox.
Right. Though I do see your point that they're the ones that stayed versus the one that were let go. However, when you look at some of the people they let go, I feel like some of that was a bit of a mistake.
Like because JDCR.
Exactly. Like JDCR, like Justin Wong, like Momochi. Like these people really draw in crowds. They really bring things to your business.
They are really well known. Yeah, they are also really well known personalities.
Yeah, they know how to work social media. They know how to really contact with the fans. You really didn't think that through, I think, when you let them go. But hey, that's business.
Plus, I mean, like, I would also say that, like, the whole, like, that on the whole, that's business thing, that Mewtwo King and that fourth guy, those guys have, like, there's a good chance that they would also be paying them less from what they were getting in Echo Fox too, because that's just like standard business shit.
Also possible.
Yeah, because for Sonic Fox, because Sonic Fox, you know, nothing needs to be said. For MK Leo, he has a good chance because he's coming in hot right off of Evo.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's a very weird situation. But as with any company that goes off, I hope that all the lower people are good and they'll find better jobs.
Yeah. Hopefully everybody gets a sponsor. Maybe we get a sponsor too.
Hey, Monster, I'm looking at you.
Monster, I'm looking at you. I like, you know what I always wondered? How come they never, like...
Sponsored us?
No, not us. Not. I don't mean us in particular, but people who are in the grind, right? Like, I can use me as an example. Because, you know, why would I not use myself as an example? I'm awesome. Because I make God Eater content, why wouldn't Namco sponsor me to help spread the word on more of their videos?
Have you applied for any of that?
Nope. Well,
but still, why don't they come to me? 5% there. I think that's your problem.
It wasn't a perfect plan. It's just like I've always seen like developed people get like already developed channels. I'm just meant growing channels in particular.
Yeah, well, they do like certain growing channels, but a lot of the times they apply for that like multiple times.
It's like getting any other job. You gotta fucking beg and plead until you piss them off enough, like just enough.
Yeah. Like, I forgot who recently. Oh, good.
I was just gonna say, like, piss them off too much, and then they'll blacklist you. Don't piss them off enough; they'll forget about you.
Yeah, fine. Just the niche.
Exactly.
I feel you. That makes perfect sense. Just like, hey, man, I really like your game enough, right? Why'd you inhale like that? That was really sharp. That scared me.
Wait, what?
Yeah, I heard moves inhale really sharply. I'm like, hey, what? Is that a terrible idea? I'm sorry.
I mean, saying to like to some guys at a big company, saying, I like your product enough. Like, I don't think they take that the right way.
Did I say enough?
Yeah.
Damn, it'd really be your own out here.
It's like you already lost the interview at that point.
Yeah, right. Yeah, I slipped up on that one. But yeah, it's just like why not do something like that? That was my main point.
Honestly, like if you can show them via like say numbers and whatnot, because they'll look at the numbers first, of course. Because they don't want to be like, oh, I did it, you got 2 views. But then like you can show after the numbers your charisma and all this, your knowledge about everything and whatnot, and then you're just good to go. But yeah, though, it's just like my mama says, finding a job is getting a job. So finding the sponsorship is getting like is a job in itself.
Yep. I'm sure fucking like Sonic Fox and Justin Wong and all these guys fucking have stories about like, oh my god, when I was getting started, like I had to fucking like stab a bitch.
Like just as well, I don't know about that, but Justin Wong talks on Twitter. This is like where he started from and how he got up there and how he worked through social media and stuff to where he is now. Like, you just gotta work the system the best you can and learn from others who've done what you've done or are doing what you're doing.
Ain't that the truth?
Well, they don't.
They really don't care.
But, yeah, I wish them all the best. But yep. Are we done with this one?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. One final note.
Oh, God.
If they're interested, they can pop in on the podcast.
First to find me. I don't even play MK11 like that, but I'll beat you.
Fucking, like, yeah, like, we have him on the show and we, like, record our match. Like, come watch me get my ass kicked.
I lost 5-0 to Sonic Fox. Billion views.
Like, hundreds of new listeners.
I just remind
he didn't perfect me once.
Yeah, right. Like,
I can be happy about that.
That was my selling point. Just like, I'm gonna let you know now. If I hit you, I done won this set. Like when I played Mario and Madden and he beat me like 100 something to like 2. I got that safety on him and I'm like, yo, I won.
It's over.
Those 100 some odd points are a social construct. I won this game.
It's funny because I actually did have an experience like that with Vanilla Marvel 3.
Nice.
Excellent.
Yeah, it was something similar too.
Yeah, because it was like this one trophy where it said like, oh, you have to beat someone who's like in the top 5 or some shit like that. I forgot what the trophy was.
Mm-hmm.
And so, like, I asked this guy, like, "Hey, man, can I get a fight?" He's like, "Sure, beat my ass." But I'm just like, "Hey, I tagged him a couple times. I'm good."
No, I actually got that trophy, and it was on the most bullshit reason too.
Oh yeah, how was it?
So, like, I literally was mashing the shit out of things. He's beating my ass, and like, we were at the final character. I was supposed to die. He missed the combo, and somehow, I don't know how I did it, I mashed out Demon on Kuma, hit him, wow, and killed him.
Oh my god.
I was like, I'm done. Fuck it.
Yeah, because for me, it was like R3v3 and shit. It was like, I think it's like, I tagged 2 of his guys and I killed 1. And I was like, I'm good.
It's over. I don't want to play anymore.
Hold that. I'm sorry.
You may have beat me 50 billion times, but that one.
Oh, God. I hate that I have that mentality. Where it's like, okay, that's one. Like, another more. Like, another 50 billion more.
But that one. But no. Alrighty. I guess we can move on to the smaller stories. Which we can start off with Terry. And Mai.
Mai is a good girl. Get over it.
Sucks about Mai, man. But like, what? And it's like, what? And it's like, it like, I feel like Sakurai made a good point.
Oh yeah.
But it's just
Sakurai
like
Sakurai himself made a good point.
Like, and it's like, I'm just sitting there thinking to myself, damn, but Bayonetta's really in this game.
Yeah, but to be fair, she's mostly clothes.
Yeah.
Yeah, see, that was my thought process, too. Just like, yeah, but she has clothes on. Mai doesn't.
Yeah.
Yep. I mean, like, well, go ahead.
Well, I was about to say, that's technically, like, one time, and that was a very alternate costume, that she was, like, kind of clothed. Mm-hmm. And it's so obscure and whatnot that I doubt he would even really in the first place, plus it's not really the character.
Yeah.
So it's like,
and we all saw what a big fanboy he is for SNK.
Exactly. Like,
would not want that.
Yeah. Like, trust me, I'm sure he wanted her in. Let's be honest here.
Oh yeah. Like, it was like, throw a dart there and fucking you'll hit any reason why he wanted her in.
Mm-hmm.
But for me, it's like, I respect the fact that he said, like, look, I wanted her in, but I couldn't get her because otherwise the ratings board would be on my ass.
Exactly.
I kind of hate how fucking, because of his translator, he's getting memed on.
I don't understand. Why? Why would you do that? That's just dumb.
I can't understand it.
He almost makes you wonder what else did he fuck up.
Kinda, yeah.
For all the good boys and girls in the world.
And I like the drawings I've been seeing where like Mai's yelling off screen saying like, I'm not a good girl.
Now all I see is like a picture of him in like a shower with 2B and Mai. Like, let us in, Sakurai.
Yeah, that fucking Smithers meme.
What the hell? Stop it. No, but so you've played Terry. I have played Terry for like a second. What are your thoughts?
I think he's really good. I really wish that Ryu and Ken were closer to what Terry's like than the way they are now. I've already told you a lot of this stuff, but of course, there's repeating because like I never said it on the pod. Yeah. Well, because I'm saying it bears repeating because I'm telling it to the people who listen to the pod. So.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's like, they're not going to see our private conversations. Fuck that.
They better not.
Dear God, I hope not.
Yeah, I've sent some lewd pictures I found on the internet.
Hey, that I've seen already. That one that you sent me moves. I already followed that person.
And I remember you also got to send me that fucking Taya gif.
Oh, and
besides the point.
Yeah, that's beside the point. We're not talking about that right now. Come on. Yeah,
we're not talking about those good girls. Yeah. Anyway,
hey, there is no judging on my channel.
You better not. Yeah.
All judges will be banned.
Judge the judges.
I'll be goddamned if a waifu player judges me.
Well, you would definitely not expect me to judge, even though.
You better not fucking judge.
Nick. I have Keelik as one of my names, but we'll just leave that there. We'll just leave that in low tier for now.
Yeah, you took that shit to the emo.
I did. No regrets.
Hey man, you played who you wanted. It's alright.
But I mean I do think he's a really good addition. He's definitely like a character who I've seen some people like, and myself personally, like just get wrecked by Terry. I do still need to practice a bit more against him versus like the standard Smash characters, because like just for fun, I've mostly been doing Ryu and Ken versus Terry.
Mm-hmm.
But it's kind of that too, that where like I do feel like he might be a tad strong at the beginning, but it could also be that I'm just like not super aware of what he's capable of. Because like I've got some shit up against like some fucking characters like fucking I dislike Ganondorf with a passion.
Pretty sure you're not the only one.
Yeah, because like what was it? I have this one friend that I fought with him in a tournament, and he says that like you know, yeah, Ganondorf doesn't have a lot of good like has one good thing, or has one thing going for him, but that one thing that he's got he's really good at it.
Mm-hmm.
And, but I was like, I would say that, like, yeah, I'm glad that fucking, I'm happy Terry's in, for sure.
Word.
And I mean, yeah, he does bring some stuff. I will also say, though, because this also kind of goes back a bit to Joker, also. I'm not the biggest fan that he's got a comeback mechanic that's as strong as it is. Yeah. Because it also makes sense, but at the same time, I also think like shit, Sakurai, why the hell do you keep making characters with comeback mechanics?
Well, it is from his game.
It is. That's also part of the reason why it's like you know I have like internal fighting, you know, because it'll be like it makes sense, but. But I mean, like overall, it's like, am I happy that Terry's in? Yes.
Mm-hmm.
How about yourself?
No, the little time I played with him, I had a blast. Me and my friend, we played Stamina Battle. And he was playing Ken, I was playing Terry. It was fun. I didn't play a lot because I didn't stay long. But what I did is pretty nice. The motions on the GameCube controller were a little bit weird at first, but after a while, it was, like, normal. Although, I would probably be, like, one of the only ones. Probably a massive taboo to any of the pro Smash players, but I really wish I could have did, like, a fight stick with him.
It's funny, because Max also says that a lot, but I'm sure that it would be the same thing that you just said. Because he's fucking... Because I was doing the Terry reveal, he'd be like, it'd be amazing, Sakurai, if you could allow fight sticks in the game.
I think he did say that.
Yeah, he said that, like, during the reveal video, and I was thinking to myself, like, yeah, and I'm sure a lot of Smash players would like to fight you on that.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure the second he said fight... there was, like, a bunch of... They're like, no!
Hardcore, no. That's enough for me, dog.
That enough.
Which, actually... We're good, Eddie?
Oh, because I'm about the meme. Because it's crazy. It's just like the Hadouken input is too complicated for Smash players.
I mean, Zero did say it himself. He didn't like that input.
He's just like, yo, what is this input shit? Just like, welcome to fighting games, bitch.
It's like. It's all those statements right there are not helping the Smash community get recognized by the FGC.
Mm-hmm.
Ain't that the truth?
But I did have a question for y'all. Well, mainly Moopsy, since he's the one who played Smash out of all this.
Okay.
That this stage, do you think it's tournament viable?
Do I think it's tournament viable? I feel like it might not, since this game, I think, would throw in the possibility of, like, touch, like, harder touch of death, or easier touch of death, I should say, to the game. Because, what was it, I think you need to get, like, somewhere around, like, I'll say, like, average of 60%, right? So that, before you can actually, like, use a move that can, like, knock an opponent out of the stage.
Well, that depends, because you can do it lower if they're closer to the wall and you do a strong enough attack, but I think they have to be, like, almost right at the wall.
Yeah, because I know that it's a mixture of that, and, like, I do think that there is a something of, like, a health where it will actually go through instead of just instant kill, but I'm not entirely sure. Because fucking Ryu and Ken don't have, like, that much, like, hardcore, or, like, that many heavy kill options.
Mm-hmm.
But that said, though, I do think that there will be some aspects of it where people wouldn't like it if it was like a tournament option. So I don't think it would probably make it in.
Yeah, that's what I figured. Even though it's like how you always say, Smash players don't like fun.
Smash players do not like fun. Oh, there's a Smash meme that I saw on Reddit, right?
Mm-hmm.
I think it was some Smash player's parents complained to Mr. Wizard about the seating, and it's like, yo, is my child not good enough at this game? And he's just like, yo, what the fuck? What the fuck is this? And then the comment section was grilling him. It's just like, yeah, that's what happens when you wanted that Smash money, you get them Smash problems, nigga.
Hey, that's how it is.
I mean, I'm not complaining. I got my ass wrecked.
Although that one guy still makes me laugh.
Yeah.
It's like, what happened? What do you think happened, idiot?
Yeah, it's like, I just fucking kicked you.
It's really self-explanatory.
What? What? You kick a guy ass or something? What's up?
It was this one dude I was fighting, this Pichu player. We ended up going.
Whoa, Pichu player. Doesn't that character kill themselves?
They do. It's kind of like a trade off that, like, they're super fast, but they do hurt themselves too.
Yeah, like they hurt themselves. Yeah,
high risk, high reward.
Yeah. He's like, say, Ibuki in Street Fighter or something.
Like, well, it doesn't really apply to Tekken really because of the health things, but like for Akuma, he tends to do a lot of damage, but tends to have the lowest health.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't apply to Tekken because they got fruit roll-ups for health.
They do have fruit roll-ups. No, but yeah, that's what basically Pichu is. Right. But no, what were you saying for him, Moopsy?
I don't even remember.
But basically, I'm trying to remember. Like, he was playing the Pichu player, right? Mm-hmm. And I believe you kicked him, and he got like knocked off or something.
Well, because what it was like we were both like fighting in the air. We both had like 120% or something like that.
Mm.
And I was doing some air kicks and. I was doing a up A, and like at one point he crossed my path, and I guess he thought that my kick shouldn't have reached him, but the animation and like the modeling shit, he like got hit with like the very corner of it, the very part at the end of it,
mm-hmm.
and you can see the zoom in and all that stuff, and he went fucking flying.
Nice, you got him. You got him with that tip range.
Yeah.
Yep. And he was just like, he turned to me and gave like a weird like what the fuck just happened kind of face, and like Jazz loves that moment.
Yeah, I was just literally like, "Yeah, what? You got knocked out, fool." No, it's just like I loved his little expression, like, "What just happened?" It's like you saw what just happened. It was
like. And he didn't say anything. He just, like, that was all expressed in a face.
Yeah.
That was some good-ass hitbox porn or something right there.
Mm. Yep.
Of course, I was going to roast him anyway because I was on Moopsy's side.
Well, yeah, like, naturally. You just got bodied, son. You fucking suck at this game.
And you got to remember, Jess is tall.
Yeah, like, that dude's more terrifying than I am. And I don't know if you notice or not, but I'm pretty terrifying in real life.
With that beard of yours, I believe it.
Oh, see, for the new job, I have to shave it.
Really?
I'm working in security, but I'm working around chemicals. And in the event of a chemical spill and I have to wear a gas mask, my beard will get in the way of it.
Yeah, that wouldn't be good.
Yeah. So it's just like...
We can't have you turning into the Joker.
Yeah, right. I'm already insane enough.
Yeah, can't have that.
Mm-hmm. And it's like, at the beginning, I didn't understand why. But since I went through orientation and stuff like that, I'm like, oh, okay, so that's why they want us clean shaven in the event that I have to wear a gas mask. I'm like, that makes sense.
Mm. Yep, yep, yep. Oh well.
What can you do?
Play Terry.
Play Terry.
Why would I play Terry? I already play the best fighting game character of all time. Yoshimitsu, baby. Man, fuck y'all. Yoshimitsu is the greatest character of all time. Hold that. Better than iteration. Which iteration? Soul Calibur 6 for looks, Tekken 7 for productivity.
I'll give you that.
But the power of reason.
For the human race? No. But, no, I think Terry, I do wonder how it's going to pan out with him as far as like tournaments and stuff go. Because, like you said, like he is very strong when he's in the super mode, the S groove. But at the same time, he also is practically almost dead.
Already?
Like, at that point, he's like at 100,
right? Oh, I thought you meant, like, my mistake. I thought you meant that, like, people were already dropping him. I was like, really? Wow.
Oh, no. People are picking him up like crazy. I was hoping that Momochi would stick with him, but he ended up going back to Ken.
I guess. Well, go ahead.
I was wondering what Eddie said.
No, yeah, I meant Eddie. Go ahead.
No. I have no thoughts. I'm not allowed to have thoughts on that. I don't play Smash.
You can always bring thoughts, Eddie.
Well, guess what? I don't have any thoughts. Shut up.
Yeah, secret thoughts. He's keeping them all to himself.
I know, right?
What? Jazz? What? No, you can't say that. You rat bastard, you.
All the best thoughts. But, like, if I had to guess why Momochi dropped him, it's probably because he actually, because one of the things about it is, since you played, is that since he still has the standard sort of like A button pressing, there's no real like pressure like system or anything like that to him. That's probably why. Because the best way for me to put it is kind of like, Terry is closer to a Smash character than Ryo and Ken are.
I was just gonna go with the fact that he just loves Ken.
I mean, that also helps, but at the same time, like, I'm sure that that's also an aspect that helped.
Yeah, I did not expect him to actually go away from Ken. Like, I expected him to play Terry a little, but like the fact that he went right back to Ken is like, I saw that coming. That's his character. That's his baby.
Like, he found his one.
Yeah.
I'm happy for him that he can make him work.
I think that was it as far as Terry goes.
Still haven't bought Banjo.
Nice.
It's funny because it's like, I still haven't bought Banjo, but when I was buying Terry, I noticed that I have enough money to get Banjo.
And then proceeded to not get Banjo.
Yep.
It's like, you know, I could buy Banjo, but McDonald's is looking real good right about now.
Excuse me, sir. Burger King.
Impossible Burgers? What?
Not even.
Burger King, McDonald's, whatever. It's better than Banjo.
This is true.
that was the main crux of my argument right there. It's just like Banjo.
I can agree.
We don't like Banjo in this podcast.
But I did see a meme about the DLC characters. It's like Joker. Oh man, but so dude, a month later, man, I hate Arsene.
Man, Arsene it's sucks. Like,
then the hero comes out. Like, who the hell is this character? Next month, ban this character. Banjo got me the most. He was just like, yeah, Banjo's here. Next month, nobody plays him.
I wonder what Terry's is gonna be.
Are you okay?
Are you okay? And then one month later, dot dot dot.
Still wondering if I'm okay. But I think we can move on to the next one, which is something we actually talked about before the podcast started, which is Sindel.
MILF of the year.
Nice.
That one's all you guys.
I do. I actually really like how they made her and Katana look alike.
That, literally, honestly, the fact that they did that really dropped. Because it's a very interesting detail you don't see too often.
Yeah, man. Parents and their kids actually looking alike. Who would have thought, right?
Right. And you would think it'd be basic stuff, but I guess not.
Do Rock and Geese even look alike?
Not really. Like, maybe other than the blonde hair? Really? Not really.
Yeah, right?
Like, honestly, if you had told me that was Geese's son, I'd okay.
I guess I'm okay, Buster Wolf.
There's almost nothing like him except the Storm, but that's about it.
It's like, yeah, sure, I can do Rapukins and Power Waves, but yeah, I mean, sure. Sure, they may be father and son, but look at this. I can do Power Waves. Look at that. Am I a part of the Howard family too? Where's my estate?
wouldn't you be part of the Bogard family?
Yeah. Yeah, because Power Waves are fucking Terry's move.
Terry Bogard. All right.
Let's say we have him in Tekken. There's no excuse.
Oh, no, that was just a moment of ignorance on my part. Like, just like, yeah, you're right.
Actually, it's funny. I do like the fact that he's a cameo in the back. But, what was I going to say about Sindel? Oh, I was going to talk about, like, on the reaction that I don't like her change. As far as her story goes,
her lore, yeah,
it literally doesn't make any sense, and I'm really hoping they have some form of explanation on the Combat Cast, which is, I believe, is going to be Tuesday, because it literally makes zero sense that they changed such a thing from her story. But so,
it was the big. Cosmic Cube that did it.
I mean, at this point, I wouldn't be surprised if Raiden had something to do with it.
Yeah, see, it was the Cosmic Cube that did it, and then they show her in a panel saying Hail Hydra.
At this point, might as well. According to her personality, she needs to stay on their throne. Hail Hydra.
It's all Fortnite's fault.
Speaking of which, they just got another announcement of a thing.
I actually know what that is. They are partnering with Star Wars. You can actually buy a Stormtrooper uniform.
Mm-hmm. This is Fortnite.
They are kicking the gaming world's ass right now.
Yeah.
They are, but I almost feel like it's like for not good reasons.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I do think that even though they are showing some signs of dying. A little bit?
Absolutely. It ain't perfect. By no means. And it's like, I don't buy battle passes or nothing like that. I'm thinking about buying this one, though. Because there's just some skins in there that just... I would lose No Nut November if I participated in foolishness like that.
Actually, it's funny you say that, because... Well, my brother was like, hey, you should ask that on the podcast. Who's still doing No Nut November?
We are thinkers in this podcast. We don't do no dumb shit like that. That'd be like, especially via the internet, too. That'd be like me just telling you, hey, go clap some cheeks today. It's like, what? No, I'm playing video games. Leave me alone.
Stay at home. Have fun, like the introvert I am.
Exactly. It's like someone else telling me not to do something to my own body. My body, my rules, right? How come we men can't use that right now, right? My body,
that'd be 2020.
Right? Like, my body, my rules. Just like, look, if we men can't tell women what to do with their babies when they're pregnant, they shouldn't be able to tell us not to nut when we don't want to. I'm just saying. That's only fair.
Boom.
Yep. I mean, we can say that. They won't want to have it, but we can say that.
Fuck them.
And that's why I'm running for president in 2020. Nah, but I don't know.
Oh yeah, Sindel's dope.
I'm still hesitant on her.
I'm still gonna buy her. I'm actually going to buy her.
Yeah, I'm getting her for sure. I'm just hoping that her tournament variations aren't disappointing.
Mm-hmm.
And the cool stuff was not disappointing, because Terminator stuff. Well, funny, at some points, a lot of this coolest stuff is kind of disappointing.
Right.
Although, to be fair, one of his best things he has is Broken as Hell, which is probably why it's not in the Terminator variation. But we'll see, come Tuesday. And I think that was fairly it for... Oh, no, there was something that recently came up today... which I don't know if you've heard of this game because it sounds indie as hell. But have you heard of the game called Tell Me Why?
Tell me why it ain't nothing.
I'm sorry.
I knew that was
What my? I'm only disappointed that y'all don't make the jokes before me. Fuck y'all.
No, it's fine. But there's a one that was made by this company that helped in making Life is Strange.
Right.
And they also helped in making Remember Me with Capcom.
Mm-hmm.
And the big story on this game is that it's going to have a transgendered protagonist.
All right.
Okay.
And it's going to be based around the story of twins.
All right.
And,
okay.
And also, like, the big reason why this is, other than the fact that it's a transgendered person, and that's a whole other thing in itself, is that they're also working with a company known as GLAAD, which is basically the LGBTQ media advocacy organization with this one. So they're putting like a lot of effort and money into this.
I think they're going about it the wrong way.
How so?
Not necessarily for transgender representation, because I mean obviously that's needed and wanted. But to go to a media site for it, or to go to like an actual group that's around it. That's like using the NAACP to represent Black people. Like it just puts a bad taste in my mouth.
Interesting.
I don't. It seems too on the nose when they go to these things like that.
Like if I'm understanding right, it's basically like you should be doing this off of your own merits and not really trying to get help to push this.
Yeah. Perfect.
See, I kind of disagree with that.
How dare you?
But maybe because we have already some kind of been on that way with the whole, I don't know if you heard about the whole Scarlett Johansson thing where she was playing a transgender person and that kind of got really out of hand and whatnot.
Because she was, because she wasn't a transgender person.
Well, and then they had somebody else going into it, and then the representation wasn't being used perfectly in that either.
All right. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, so it's like, I feel like what they're really trying to do is really get a general sense of what they should be going into this, and why wouldn't you take it from somebody who's really doing this, right? Yeah. Like, why would you just take it on your own merit when you might not even know what that might even mean? You know what I'm saying?
I know what you're saying.
I think it kind of depends on who's helming the project. Because if it's like, say, some like random person that's not like transgender or anything like that, then they probably wouldn't. Then it kind of makes sense why, because they'd be like, okay, I don't get this, so like, how would this go about it? But I mean, like, I guess the best way to put it is, well, because I'm trying to put like this phrase it in such a way that is like, yeah, I guess it's, you wouldn't want someone, you wouldn't, the other end of the spectrum would be like, you wouldn't want him to be going like every other moment is like, is this scene transgender enough?
Which, yeah, this makes sense.
Yeah, I think that was more to my point too.
Yeah, which I can understand that point, which is why I think they went with a trans actor as well.
Yeah.
To kind of mitigate that.
Yeah, because that's a step in the right direction.
Wouldn't it like, well, because wouldn't a lot of it help if it was like more of like a writer? Wouldn't like that solve a lot of like a lot of the stuff?
Yes and no, because technically there's a whole another problem you can have in that aspect, which is like we've already been saying, it could go too far one way to be off-putting to people who are not really into this, but they want to learn, say, per se,
right? Like not sound preachy.
Yeah.
Yeah,
perfect example that we always bring up, Moopsy, a feminist. Like, there's one way of looking at it, but what is the way we tend to look at it?
Pretty much like our own point of view.
Exactly. So then you get something that's like supposed to show you how it's supposed to really be, But then you get those extremists that's just like...
Yeah, because I guess like, well, nah, I don't know if that wording would necessarily work, but so keep going.
Yeah, it's like, it could definitely work in the way you were saying, like a transgender person being writing in and whatnot. But at the same time, it could also fall into that trap that we're trying to avoid as well.
Right.
It really depends on the, quote, person writing it, in my opinion.
It does. I do kind of feel, though, that, like, given modern times, it's kind of hard to find someone that is, like, I guess you could, like that is primarily a writer, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Because sometimes, there will be, like, some people who is like, oh, I write shit, but then it's just, like, they're constantly asking themselves this question of, like, is this representation enough, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And if it's too far in that direction, then people are going to lose interest, and then, like, it's going to be like, well, you done fucked up, like, an important project.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, dog, I agree. And, like, and it's, like, their reasoning for making this game, if that started off wrong, then it's already going to be dead on arrival.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, hold on. Man, what you want?
But,
I don't know.
It just got announced today, really, for all the stuff and whatnot.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, there's still a lot of stuff probably needs to be working on. Honestly, my main thing is almost like what we've been saying is the writing, but not for the thing you might be thinking of. Is that I hope the dialogue's actually good because.
What?
Well, I was saying, like, I've played Life is Strange, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I know a lot of people love that game, but you can't deny some of that stuff is cringy.
I wouldn't be surprised. I never got around to playing that.
Yeah. I was going to stream it until somebody, a YouTuber, decided to spoil it, something huge, in the goddamn game in the thumbnail. I hate YouTubers.
My fucking horse.
But it's the writing can be good, but a lot of times I feel like it's a bit cringy, so I do hope they get a really nice writer this time.
Yeah, because I think that like a good chunk of the stuff that would really make the game engaging, it would help if it was like, you know, if it was like a writer that, yes, they were talking about a lot of this stuff, but without going so far as going into preachy territory, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Which I mean, I almost feel like nowadays it's starting to get like less and less like prominent. You know, you'll find a lot of people who will be more like interested in the message rather than how they're telling it.
Yeah, I agree with that. No, but just wanted to hit that one real quick. It literally just happened like a couple hours ago. It's just like, oh, well, might as well hit this one.
Hey, so we finally got some breaking news.
Yep. Yep, yep, yep. Take that comment section. I read you.
Post more comments. We love seeing this shit.
I know, right? But I think that's all I really had for the smaller ones. Did y'all have anyone?
Not necessarily. Like the biggest thing I had done with if it was worth like fucking mentioning to the small stories was basically telling everybody else what I thought about that impossible burger, but that's about it.
Hey, floor is yours.
I mean, I don't have much to say because it's actually like it's not bad, you know, like because I told Jess that fucking it tastes basically like any other Burger King burger, and because it's supposedly like the whole, oh, it's a fucking, it's a vegan burger, like no animal products and all that stuff. Although, to be fair, I did ask mine with cheese.
You monster! No.
Think of the cows! But, yeah, like, I did think that it tasted, like, pretty good. I had never, like, really seen, like, the patty, like, I never bothered to, like, check out the patties, is the best way to say, so I can't say anything about, like, the visual stuff.
Hmm.
And I don't know, like I was also saying, I don't know if this is, like, a common thing with, like, Whoppers or anything like that, but they kind of did have, like, a bit of a peanut smell to it. But
I think that is for the bun. I'm not 100% sure. I haven't had Burger King in a while.
Right. But. But yeah, it's one of those things where it might taste only slightly different, but you know, it's like it's good enough so that it's if you're not really thinking about it, you're just eating it like any other product without actually considering like what it is. It tastes exactly the same.
Hmm. Which I did tell him, like, I probably will try one soon myself, because I've always been kind of, yeah. I've always been kind of interested in it, especially since we had that story of people going apeshit because the delivery person forgot the Impossible Burger or whatever and got them like a regular Whopper, which I was just like, what's the difference?
I mean, based off of taste, you wouldn't really know. Yeah.
Yeah.
Because another thing too, that is because one of the taste comparisons would be that like it doesn't have as much of the whole smoky flavor to it.
Mm-hmm.
So like when you do bite down on it, it's kind of like it is lacking that a little bit. But that said, I've also eaten some regular ass burgers that some people say like, oh my god, you fucking have to eat this. Like, I'm gonna piss some people off right now. Like either like Five Guys or In-N-Out or some shit like that. They'll say like, oh my god, this is the best shit, and I'm like, it's all right, a little bland for my taste. Yeah, they are. They really are. I just made so many enemies.
Five Guys is too expensive.
It is.
Well, yeah.
And I was also like throwing shade at In-N-Out and making lots of enemies. But
I didn't have an In-N-Out, so
yeah, I think you have like a separate chain over there that's basically like as popular, but like In-N-Out doesn't reach over there.
Yeah, I want to say it's a Cookout, but I'm not sure.
Yeah, I'm not sure either. But the point is that like, you know, fucking the Impossible Burger is like it's good. You know, if you like the Whopper, the tastes are slightly different, like 10-15% difference.
Mm.
And I would say, yeah, go check it out.
Word. Works for me. Anything else for small stories?
Mm-mm. Well, no, I don't got nothing.
Hmm. All right, I think that will be it.
All right. So, any plugs?
Find me all things Cosmo Jazz. On Twitch, I'm going to be adding a new extension. It's going to be a very interactive extension, and I hope that a lot of people use it. Because
a lot of people stop gasping.
No, keep gasping. It's fun. But it's going to be more interactive for like the chat and me as well. So, and it's going to be helping me with something I've been trying to do for a long time. I'm not going to say what it is yet. So if you want to see what it is.
Why would you bring it up?
So they can come to the Twitch.
Yeah.
And see what it is.
That sounds like clickbait.
I mean, if they click on it, it works, right?
He's not lying yet.
Use of can't.
It's kind of the point. They're getting interested, and you're ruining the moment. You're ruining it.
You're just like that guy with Life is Strange.
No, I'm just playing. But let's see. Other than that, I finally have the music I need for my outro, so I can finally work on that this weekend. Thanks to Raz.
Dope.
Hey.
Hello,
I say hi.
Will do. And I think that's about it. Happy November, everybody, and
make sure to nut.
If that's your thing.
If that's your prerogative, yeah, man, go for it.
Yeah. For me, it's like fucking Twitch, YouTube, Twitter. Follow me all, Mr. Moopsy. For me, it's this weekend. I'm finally gonna get off my ass and keep working on that compilation video.
Nice,
good shit.
It's it's been a bigger pain in the ass this time around because I've been trying to find like lots of memes and shit, and I've been trying to find like a lot of like green screen stuff as well.
Nice.
Which I mean, that's a pain. But it's like I was saying, It's like I have to now that I have the green screen stuff, now I have to chop it up into different segments. So that's gonna be fun.
But I do not want to be you right now.
Yeah, I'm debating whether or not to like get some of the smaller stuff that I do have available and just find a way to cram it in there, or if I should like actually take the time to do all that stuff and then really try to go through everything. But I don't know, like I've already like taken too long. Plus, I also have to make sure that I do all my fucking schoolwork and shit. But thankfully, I am passing my class.
Yay!
Oh, I feel like that's much more important.
Yeah. And, like, this is the class I need to transfer schools, so.
Oh. Then, yeah, man, fuck that compilation video. By comparison.
Right. I got you. But I'll try to pop it and do it every once in a while, like work on the vid once in a while, just so that like I can keep like my I can keep from getting rusty on that shit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, man, I agree.
But yeah, other than that, there was also that fucking dopey ass picture I was working on for Inktober's up on my Twitter as well.
Mm-hmm.
Nice.
And that's about all I got.
Okay. You guys can find me on YouTube at Baker. I have been taking a huge break. I'm trying to get back into making videos again. I made a mistake on trying to get the new job. I made a mistake at orientation that I just was not ready to do that day. I messed up in the sense that I had made the most minor mistake in an application, and instead of going back to fix it, they're just like, nope, sorry, you just have to go home and wait a few business days before you can come back up here and then do this thing again. Smallest mistake in the world. And I had that happen to me. So I was originally going to start today, but because that got pushed back, I'm like, okay, well, I'll just do my usual stuff until I'm back on track for that.
No, well, you'll get it.
Yep.
I'm hoping that they stick with me because they wouldn't waste all that money having me do numerous drug tests and then go up to safety council to do all this stuff. For a little mistake like that to happen, it's just like, you know what? We don't want you.
You could just go to them and say, hey, don't you know I'm part of the No Name Podcast, you nerds?
Yeah, 26 episodes. Watch that shit. it's even in a playlist.
Excuse me, I have a call to make.
Word.
But yeah, that's it. I'm currently streaming on Twitch now. After we're done here, I'm probably going to continue streaming. Probably go take a small break, go walk away, go stretch or something. And then I'll probably continuing to stream for a while after that.
Dope.
I'm wondering if like either Saturday or Sunday I should stream Pokemon.
Nice. Do it.
Yeah, that's the goal. That's the goal that I got going right now.
Cool.
Nice. So I believe that's everybody's business in order. So with that in mind, I would like to say thank you everybody for joining the No Name Podcast. Be sure to join, to like, comment, and subscribe Jazz's channel shit. And I think that'll do it for this episode.
Podcast over. See ya.
Later.
And we're out.
Yep.
Nice. Don't have to edit that out.
Yeah, right.
Fucking, like, I've been burping so a ton because I like the Coke I was drinking was fucking room temperature.
Yeah, that'll do it. But I am going to eat the rest of my wings.
And share I'm gonna... that
shit. No. I'll be in your chat, Eddie.
Ballin'.
I will. I'm gonna go get some dinner, and then I'm gonna set up to stream Monster Hunter because it's my weekly thing with my friends.
Dope. Oh yeah, you still gotta be up for and then well, I think it's only two people though. The arena is only two people, right?
For the new weapon, huh?
Well, I want the armor.
So
I can just blaze through things.
Oh, the guild armor.
Yeah,
that is only two players.
Yeah, piss. You still have that, Mitch?
I can help you with that tomorrow.
Alrighty. Well, yeah, I mean, tomorrow. I'm not doing that tonight.
Oh, yeah, of course. But yeah, because pretty much I'm going to be open to help, I think, after 11 o'clock your time.
I should be somewhere. We'll see.
All right, but I mean, it's gonna be like that for Saturday and Sunday. So, like, any time after that, I'll be good.
All right, and then I was gonna ask you and Lee for something. I can't remember what it was. If it comes to me, I'll tell you, Eddie.
Cool.
But I will catch you all later.
Peace.
Later.
All right, so now I'm going to run an ad. I'll run an ad, go walk away, and then I'm going to be doing, like, co-op stuff.